This is Diogo Moura from University of São Paulo, and in this video I will discuss our experience with balloon sphincteroplasty during NRCP. This technique was initially described by Staritz as an alternative to endoscopic sphincterotomy in order to minimize adverse events. However, high rates of posterior pancreatitis have been reported, especially in non-Asian countries, subsequently resulting in the technique essentially being abandoned. Nowadays, the technique is mostly utilized for specific indications, such as patients with coagulopathy or altered anatomy, especially after gastrointestinal surgery for patients in whom sphincterotomy is risky or technically challenging. Additionally, large balloon dilation is usually helpful in complex biliary stones. Recently, a meta-analysis showed a similar incidence of posterior pancreatitis among patients who underwent sphincterotomy alone, balloon dilation alone, and balloon dilation after sphincterotomy. In this video, we will discuss two cases involving balloon sphincteroplasty. The first one is a case involving complex stone removal. In this picture, we see a dilated common bile duct with multiple biliary stones. It's important to understand, to perform a safe procedure, the dilation must not be larger than the CBD diameter. It's also critical to dilate until disruption of the radiological waste. Be patient during balloon inflation to avoid abrupt disruption of the waste. When you disrupt it, you must stop inflation to reduce the risk of serious adverse events. In our experience, we keep the balloon inflated for 5 minutes to prevent bleeding, as this is the time to achieve coagulation. Coming back to case 1, the dilation until the disruption of the radiological waste can be observed in the red arrow. After the papillary large balloon dilation, all the stones were removed, include some large stones as shown in this video. The picture here shows all biliary stones in the duodenum, with the cholangiograph confirming the success of the procedure. A recent meta-analysis showed that an isolated endoscopic sphincterotomy was associated with more post-ERCP bleeding and increased need for mechanical lithotripsy compared to sphincterotomy associated with balloon dilation. Another randomized trial comparing cholangioscopic lithotripsy versus large balloon dilation in the management of complex biliary stones demonstrated that both techniques are effective and safe for removing these stones. A subsequent meta-analysis confirmed this result. However, conventional techniques offers the advantage of a shorter procedure time. Next, I would like to discuss the second case of this presentation, involve an ERCP in a patient after a Buhl 2 surgery. In the afferent loop, the major papilla was identified. Different from the normal anatomy, in a Buhl 2 patient, the CBD axis is located at 5 o'clock position and not 11 o'clock. During initial cannulation attempts, the pancreatic duct was cannulated. To prevent post-ERCP pancreatitis and to facilitate access into the CBD, a pancreatic stent was placed. After successful pancreatic stent placement, the CBD was easily cannulated. Contrast injection showed a quite large stone, and due to the challenged position, the decision was made to proceed with a balloon sphincteroplasty. The balloon was inflated under endoscopic and fluoroscopic guidance until the disruption of the radiological waste. In some cases, endoscopic visualization may be helpful to reduce the risk of adverse events. When the balloon was deflated, moderate bleeding was observed. In cases such as this, we inflate the balloon again and keep this inflated for 5 minutes to allow for hemostasis. When the balloon is deflated again, and if bleeding is still occurring, you should keep the guide wire at least until the bleeding site is identified. Then, an endoscopic hemostatic approach can be performed based on local experience. In our case, after deflation of the balloon for the second time, no active bleeding was observed. Next, the CBD stone was visualized and successfully extracted by balloon sweeping of the bile duct. The occlusion cholangiogram showed no residual stone or contrast extravasation. Finally, despite a laceration, endoscopic evaluation showed no signs of perforation or active bleeding. In case of laceration, hemoclip or stent placement associated with antibiotics may be used to avoid late adverse events. Appropriate hemoclip selection is essential given the use of a duodenoscope. Some hemoclips do not work well in this scope. As perforation may occur, the use of CO2 is highly recommended. In case of perforation, first, do not panic. If it occurs, metal stent placement and antibiotics are recommended, and the patient should be admitted for closer monitoring. In conclusion, balloon sphincteroplasty is a safe and effective technique. Balloon sphincteroplasty should be used in select cases based on personal experience.